In this lesson, we will be creating basic forms for our database. So why do you need forms? Well, in the last lesson, you saw that one way to get data into your database is by entering it directly into the tables. That method is fine if you are already familiar with the database and the formats that the data should be in. But the other users of your database may not enter data into the tables exactly the way you want them to. Well, in Access, you can create a form that your users can use to populate the table instead of working directly in the table itself. Access forms look a lot like some of the forms you may have filled out at the bank or at work or at school. With an Access form, you see one record at a time, but in a table, you see all the records at once. I've already created two basic forms, the Orders form, where I'll enter an order for one customer that is purchasing a book or books, and a Customers form for entering a customer's information. The Customers form has a drop-down list for the state field. This makes it really easy for the user to enter a valid state abbreviation. The form you'll be creating is the Books form. It will be used to enter books as they come into our store inventory. We're also going to set up a list like the one in our customers form to make selecting a book category easy. So now, let's create our own form to make data entry easy for the person entering the new books. First, select the table that most closely relates to the form you want to create. In this case, we're going to choose the books table. Next, click on the Create tab and the Form command in the Forms group. This automatically generates a form based on table content. It's not the best option since you don't control what it looks like without modifying the layout, but you can always go back and change the layout and colors later, so this is the option we're going with for now. Plus, we want all the fields from our books table to appear on our form, which this option does automatically for us. There are other options for creating forms, but we'll talk about that later. Access automatically called our form the same as the table it is based on, but you can rename it whatever you want by saving it and entering a new name. Books is just fine for what we're doing. Down here, we have our navigation buttons for our form. I can go to the first record, the previous record, the next record, the last record, or I can choose to enter a new blank record. In our next lesson, we'll actually start entering data in our form to create new records.